Yeah, we'll get started. So I just wanted to say thank you for giving me this opportunity, okay, to present or to address the gathering, okay, for succeed your career in life sciences, or I will just share some tips, okay, to ace your interview basically. So having 3 point around 5 years of experience, okay, I feel proud that I am addressing this gathering, okay. And also my juniors, right? And so I will get started. Okay, I'll not waste much time. I'll just give a quick agenda of our discussion today. So we'll get started with my introduction, and I will share some experience, okay, from my own journey, okay, throughout. And then if you have any queries or follow-up questions, then I can clarify your doubts accordingly. So to get started, next slide, please. Yeah, so this is a quote, okay, I like very much, okay. Sir, if you can reshare it again, I think it's got stuck. So it's by Maya Angelou, okay. So sometimes you do a lot of things, okay, or you say many things, okay, but people will forget at the end of the day. But people will always remember, okay, how you make them or made them feel during your conversation or during your course of action or during your interaction with them, okay. So as I mentioned, right, I having a 3.5 years of experience, I am still learning. And I'm still gathering experience from different like personality in our field, or from my manager, or from my juniors as well. Because if you want to grow in your career, right, you have to continuously learn and you have to continuously explore different things. Okay, so in that note, see, right now I will. Like you can go to Google, okay, whatever I will be sharing today or whatever I will be presenting, you will get a lot of blogs or a lot of information regarding that. But what I wanted to make this session more interesting is that I will be sharing my life experience, or I will be sharing some experience which I have come across in these 3 years or when I was a student, okay. So yeah, so I just wanted to tell you that you can crack the interviews, okay? It's not a big deal. You go through some Google documents or Google, go through, like explore Google, do some practice about the like mock interview, or do some practice, like practice some questions, okay, which frequently asked by the interviewers. You will crack the interviews. But the most importantly, I want to give you a experience, okay, from the real life situations, okay, what as a recruiter we feel, or what as an interviewer we feel, okay. So next slide, please, sir. Yeah, so just to give a quick introduction of myself, I think earlier someone have introduced, I think Gino has introduced myself in very, like, yeah, very descriptive manner. But I will just take this opportunity also to introduce myself. As you all are aware, right, my name is Sumon Sarkar. Okay, I am a part of Global Talent Advisory Team and working as the associate recruiter at Cohance by LabCorp. I was alumni of Kristu Jayanti College, and I completed my BBA from 2014 to 17. Yeah, like the batch of from 2014 to 17, I was part of that batch. And after my graduation, okay, I joined Cohance, and basically I am from West Bengal, city called Calcutta. And after my studies, okay, after my schooling, okay, I did tried some of the colleges, okay, in Kolkata. Some of the colleges could be like one of, so I wanted to be part of one college, okay, St. Xavier's in Kolkata. It's one of the most famous college in So this is a quote, okay, I like I like very much, okay. Sir, if you can reshare it again, I think it's got stuck. So it's by Maya Angelou, okay. So sometimes you do a lot of things, okay, or you say many things, okay, but people will forget at the end of the day. But people will always remember, okay, how you make them or made them feel during your conversation or during your course of action or during your interaction with them, okay. So as I mentioned, right, I having a 3.5 years of experience, I am still learning and I'm still gathering experience from different like personality in our field or from my manager or from my juniors as well. Because if you want to grow in your career, right, you have to continuously learn and you have to continuously explore different things. Okay, so in that note, see, right now I will, like, you can go to Google, okay, whatever I will be sharing today or whatever I will be presenting, you will get a lot of blogs or a lot of information regarding that. But what I wanted to make this session more interesting is that I will be sharing my life experience or I will be sharing some experience which I have come across in these 3 years or when I was a student, okay. So yeah, so I just wanted to tell you that you can crack the interviews, okay. It's not a big deal. You go through some Google documents or Google, explore Google, do some practice about the like mock interview or do some practice, like practice some questions, okay, which frequently asked by the interviewers. You will crack the interviews, but the most importantly, I want to give you a experience, okay, from the real life situations, okay, what as a recruiter we feel or what as an interviewer we feel, okay. So next slide, please, sir. Yeah. So just to give a quick introduction of myself, I think earlier someone have introduced, I think Gino has introduced myself in very very descriptive manner, but I will just take this opportunity also to introduce myself. As you all are aware, right, my name is Sumon Sarkar. Okay, I am a part of Global Talent Advisory Team and working as the associate recruiter at Covance by LabCorp. I was alumni of Kristu Jayanti College and I completed my BBA from 2014 to 17. Yeah, like the batch of from 2014 to 17, I was part of that batch. And after my graduation, okay, I joined Covance and basically I am from West Bengal, a city called Calcutta. And after my studies, okay, after my schooling, okay, I did tried some of the colleges, okay, in Kolkata, some of the colleges could be like one of, so I wanted to be part of one college, okay, St. Xavier's in Kolkata. It's one of the most famous college in Kolkata, okay. But due to some circumstances, okay, since I was not having maths that time, okay, I had a opportunity also to do some summer class, okay, that college or that university conducts during the summer vacation, okay, after your plus two. But I missed that opportunity, okay. So that's why I thought maybe let's try something new. Let's come out from the comfort zone. And when I went to Bangalore, I was alone, all alone. And my admission was like, I came for other college, but somehow I got into Kristu Jayanti. And I think that is the best thing happened in 2014. Okay, because when I came to Kristu Jayanti, okay, I was like, it's, to be honest, it's a complete culture difference. Okay. the culture I come from and the culture that I was like in past 6 years I was into, it's like completely different. And so yeah, but I love Bangalore for its pleasant weather, the culture I told you, right, and the fun loving people. So a little bit about myself. And so currently what I am doing, so my role at Covance is to recruit for the best talent, okay, and to ensure that Covance continues to grow and to be a best, like, great place to work for. Okay, beside my current role, I also enjoy working on different recruitment activities such as talent engagement, talent mapping, talent analytics, HR analytics, and also involved in different HR projects. Apart from my this core roles, okay, I also currently lead the campus recruitment for Covance India. And in recent, like in yeah, last month only, we have closed our campus recruitment activities, and we have onboarded around 78 interns, okay, for the batch of 2021. So this is what, like, it was a crazy time. It was during November, yeah, September, October, November, December. You know, four to 5 months were crazy. It was a great exposure. Virtually conducted all the campus recruitment event, conducted the pre-placement presentation, and so forth. And if I go to my hobbies side, I like to read and watch travel blogs. Okay, it could be anything. It could be new to. It could be on paper. It could be book. Anything. And yeah, and I like to travel. Okay, but I like to travel for food. I like to taste or try out new food. But in recent times, to be honest, I haven't traveled anywhere. Okay, I only. Yeah, I think on December, I moved to Calcutta. Okay, I was in Bangalore till December. I spent my lockdown in Bangalore. It was a great experience, to be honest. Far from family, to be alone at home, at room. It was a great experience. And yeah, I love playing football. It's my, like, I am passionate about playing football. I represented college and school, and also I represented college in different tournaments, and I was a part of college football team as well. Yeah, so this is a brief about my background. Next slide, please, sir. Okay, great. So now I believe that we have all the BSc Life Sciences final year students, right? So, yeah, so I just wanted to focus on some few points, okay? I will not give you like some kind of philosophy or anything, but it's just something what I had practiced in my past, okay? Just through my journey, or I have seen people, okay? I have seen leaders, I have seen my seniors, okay, who have kind of followed this career path, okay, to reach where they are right now. So first, you should have a vision, like vision, okay, what you want to pursue, what you want to achieve, okay, over the next maybe 10 years. 10 years is too much time, but I will not tell 10 years, but it should be like, 7 to 8 years, okay, or you should have a set vision, okay, that I want to be a leader in life sciences field, or I want to have my, in 10 years, I should have 10 or 15 patents, okay? So this, like, you have to specify a vision, okay? Or you have, and based on that vision, you have to put your short and long-term goals, basically, okay? What, to reach to that vision, okay? What activities or steps, okay, I should do, or I should carry forward, okay, to go to that vision, okay? So now, for example, you guys are in BSc Life Sciences, right? Right now, you are doing your undergraduate. So now, some of you want to be, like, some of you want to pursue your post-graduate, okay? Some wants to go for your job. Okay, some wants to take a career break and think of something and then or some wants to prepare for some exams. So for that, you have to specify your vision, okay, what you want to be, and you have to work through that vision, okay. And also the next, what you have to take care of, what is the qualification, okay, required, okay, or what is the skills, okay, what knowledge or what kind of capability I should build over the period of time, okay, to achieve my goals or to reach there, okay, where you have like visualize yourself to be after maybe 7 years or 8 years or 9 years. So you have to understand what are the skills required, okay, what courses you should require. For example, so you have heard of research scientists, right? So for example, if you want to be research scientist or research assistant, okay, at this point you have to pursue your MSc masters, okay, but because the role that you will be performing, okay, it's more technical, okay, you have to gather more knowledge, okay, like by your like subject knowledge, basically what I'm trying to tell, subject knowledge. See, because when you will be working, right, you will be going, like you will be going through HPLC analysis, okay, some different analysis that you guys perform, right, in biotech or in microbiology, what, like at the lab analysis. So for that, you have to acquire certain subject knowledge, okay. So for that, you have to understand what should I do, okay. If I do not do my MSc or do not do my PhD, then I cannot able to reach there. Because why I'm telling this, some job have minimum criteria, okay, educational qualification criteria, okay. So if I talk about such as lab technician, okay, in some companies they are okay to explore BSc life sciences, but some companies will look for particularly MSc life sciences, some will look for PhD, okay. So right now you have to understand, okay, what is your aspiration, okay, if you really wanted to be a research assistant or lab technician, and what are the skills required. Now for example, I'm not sure if we have bioinformatics course in KJC, but for example, if anyone wants to go into informatics field, okay, where you want to deal with some data or something like that, okay, then you have to acquire some skills like Python, okay, or you have to go through some data analytics course, okay, also you do some programming course, okay, because there you need to have those skills, okay, for example, to slice down the big data, okay. But for example, okay, you guys do projects, right, as a part of your curriculum, you have some sample size for the project, like around 50 sample size or like 20 sample size. Now you have the data, how you can visualize or how you can drill down the data to. So for that, you can use Excel. But right now, where the technology is moving, where the company is moving, the companies are moving more into Python or some other analytics course. So for you guys also, I think you have some biostatistics course in the curriculum, right? So there you can get that data analytics flavor, okay? Then if you are really interested, okay, then you can look for other courses, okay, online courses, okay, outside, okay? And also you have to find someone in your network as well, okay, who can share or who can guide you, okay, what to do, the next step. Then you should, so that's where the mentor will come. But before that, you should have a self-belief, okay? If you have set some vision, okay, or mission, like, or goals, or you want to achieve maybe 10 years down the line, you should have self-belief or confident, okay? If I am capable, or if I have the capability to pursue pursue what I have, my aim is. So for that, what you have to do, what I have done over the period of time, see, when I started my career, okay, or when I completed my graduation like BBA, or when I was in my last semester, okay, I was very confused, to be honest. What to do? Shall I do MBA or shall I go for higher studies in Canada, Australia? I had different like opportunities, but what I thought of is I want, like, see, I have already a set vision that I want to pursue my career in HR, and I wanted to be a leader in HR maybe in 15 years or 20 years down the line. But for that, I have to really understand, okay, right? What, like, on the ground, how it looks like. Like, see, when someone, see, I'm telling right now, okay, I'm addressing you guys, or you might have watched some videos or anything, but so for example, I just give a quick example. So when you see some stunts, okay, or like action movies, okay, where they jump from building to building here and there, right? So that time you might think that it's very easy, right? For they are jumping from here and there, but on the ground, what effort they should really put, okay, to make that like action on the screen. So that's why I have tried testing my capabilities. Okay, so for example, if I started as recruitment coordinator, I have different path. Okay, I could have gone to recruitment operations. Okay, I could have gone to sourcing. Okay, I could have gone to recruiter right now where I am. So, but I wanted to go in recruiter field. So that's why I have tested my knowledge. I have got into different project, okay, on the job trainings, okay. So, and also you have to be focused, very much focused, okay. If you deviate from your like what you are focusing, okay, that time that's where you will miss the dots, okay. So that's why always be focused. You will have a situation or challenges where you will get demotivated, okay, but to tell it's okay. Like it can happen, right? But now you have to embrace that. Okay, you have to embrace that. You have to look into the big picture. Okay, if I am getting demotivated, okay, if I am getting demotivated, okay, so that time, how, like, why I am getting demotivated? It could be some challenges. Embrace the challenge. Okay, it could be some failure, embrace that failure, okay, and learn from that failure, okay. People can fail. I have failed many times. I have failed, yeah, right now also, maybe in my current role, I have failed. But what I have done is that I have self-evaluated my failures. I have identified where I have missed, okay, why I couldn't able to reach there, but however that person has reached there. What he or she has done differently, what I didn't do differently. So you have to be focused, you have to continuously believe in yourself, you have to set a vision, you have to work on your skills, you have to develop your skills. So for that, you need a good mentor, okay? So mentor could be anyone. So at Covance, okay, like Covance is such a beautiful organization, to be honest. In my initial career, I have got good mentors, or even my manager right now, okay? So, like, you have to find someone, okay? Who, because this, like, wherever you go, right? After your undergraduation, after your post-graduation, after your PhD, okay? This is where your academics ending. Your new career journey starting, where your professional front. That time you should believe, or you have to take advice from someone, okay, where they can help you guys, okay, from their past experience, okay. You will find mentors, okay, who are positive thinker or negative thinker. So you have to evaluate those kind of mentors, okay, based on what kind of positive vibes you are getting. If you are going too much negative, just I will, to be honest, I will tell that look for other mentors. It's not your right mentor, okay? Always look for positiveness, okay? And yeah, so and also always learn, okay? Continuously learn, always. So for, as I told you, right, during your course, like core subjects, you take up some certified courses. Okay, it could be anything. It could be data analytics. It could be your lab operations. It could, like, you have so many online courses. Okay, or it could be communication. Okay, see, communication is something you have to improve on over the period of time. Okay, so it could, like, it should not be like you are talking or you are developing accent, or you're talking in British English or American English. You have to communicate in such a manner that you are like explaining or whatever you are delivering, okay, the other person should understand or without any ambiguity. Okay, so here, but apart from this, what are the career opportunities, if you ask me, for life science, irrespective of MSc, undergraduations, or like postdoctoral, right? So there are a lot of things. Okay, so you have, I think you guys have come across like wet labs and dry labs, right? You have one side is wet lab, okay, where you deal with chemicals, right? The lab operations. You have there, you have so many opportunities. You have drug discovery, you have a research scientist, you have like lab technician, and so more. And if you come to dry lab, okay, you is basically you have to work behind the computers, okay, where you will be not interacting with any of the labs or any of the sample on like, yeah, but you will be dealing with a sample with terms of the data, with terms of the analytics, with terms of the finding. So